not a night gala or something, not really, right? So who we are and what we are doing here.
So the cameraman maybe can show us around.
Let's have an all around view here. Looks fun, right?
Yeah.
From up there it looks like a cinema. Yeah, it looks pretty clear. So we are standing on the stage of an auditorium here. And up there looks like a cinema, and here it could be a perfect venue for all kinds of cultural performances, right?
Yeah, but we are not going to dance or sing. We are trying to explain the China-Vietnam relations here.
So sorry to disappoint you, we're not bringing any performance, but who we are actually correspondents with China's national news agency, Xinhua. And we are covering overseas trips of Chinese President Xi Jinping. So here we are at the capital city of Vietnam, Hanoi, because Chinese President Xi Jinping is here for a state visit and for the 25th APEC summit.
So just how do you see the China-Vietnam relations?
Like, we have a very good relationship dating back to the ancient time and also after the establishment of the PRC and later in the new era, right? So China and Vietnam, as we often say, we have been good partners, good friends, good comrades, right?
And we also have established comprehensive strategic cooperative partnership.
Yes. So for those who just joined us, we are correspondents with Xinhua News Agency, and for this live streaming, we're trying to explore all the evidence of close cooperation and friendship between China and Vietnam, because Chinese president is visiting Vietnam right now. So join us, and we're going to introduce this. Oh, by the way, we forgot to say, this is actually the auditorium inside the China-Vietnam Friendship Palace. And it's a landmark project. It's sponsored by Chinese government with a total investment of nearly $50 million.
The whole construction started in 2013.
Yes.
And I think it's already
completed. It looks great to me.
Yeah.
It could be put into use right away. And this place, I'm guessing it will be the venue for large-scale cultural performances. As you might already know that China has in total 56 ethnic groups, and Vietnam has 54 ethnic groups. So the two countries have a very diverse ethnic culture, and I'm pretty sure that if they bring all the performances together, it would be great. Yeah. And Vietnam has a population of over 94 million, and China has a bit over 1.35 billion. Like, we are neighbors and we're linked by mountains and rivers.
We also have very strong economic and trade ties with nearly $100 billion trade volume last year.
Yes. So we're going through all the aspects of China-Vietnam relations one by one. And first, we're going to explore this place a little bit. And to start from the auditorium, let's walk around that. Join us. By the way, this is a three-story building, and apart from this auditorium, it also has the main hall outside. And to its sides, it has tea house, it has the traditional Chinese medicine therapy room. Yes, and also a library, and of course, office buildings. So this is a perfect place for China-Vietnam cultural exchanges, and also a great venue for the local events like diplomatic receptions, large ceremonies, right? Yeah. This is a freshly room right here.
Yeah.
It smells fresh too. Yeah, it's quite new. And it will be put into use very soon. Right. Very nice. So now we are taking you to the, let's go have tea house. Would be good, right?
Yeah.
Yes. As you might already know that Chinese are a big fan of tea.
And also Vietnam, they also like drinking tea, just like they like drinking coffee.
Yeah. Let's get inside. It's not open yet, so it's pretty new. And shall we go find a seat?
Yeah.
we should have a more broad view of this place before we sit down and talk about politics and economy and culture, right?
Just show us around the tea house.
And for those who just tune in, we are at the tea house, which is a part of the China-Vietnam Friendship Palace, newly built grand building, a landmark project to mark the two countries' friendship and cooperation. I just love those pillows. It goes so well with our dresses today. It's by accident. We did not do that before, right? Yeah. It's pretty nice. So this is the tea house, and we're sitting quite comfortably on the sofa. And for today's live streaming, as we said, we're looking for evidence of China-Vietnam friendship. So this is the capital city of Vietnam, Hanoi. And shall we start from... We have a lot to talk about China-Vietnam relations,
shall
right?
Shall we start from the diplomacy? History?
Yeah, yeah, totally.
Actually, this is actually Chinese President Xi Jinping's second state visit to Vietnam. The first visit by President Xi was in 2015, first state visit by him.
This is the second as the president, right?
Yes.
And also that it's been twice for the past 3 years that the two top leaders of the two countries and also the two parties visited each other within
the same
year.
Yes.
So that proves a lot about our political cooperation and mutual trust, right?
Also, we just finished the 19th National Congress of CPC in China. Vietnam is the first country visited by President Xi after this 19th National Congress.
Yes, just for those who are not familiar with China's Communist Party's 19th National Congress. So China's Communist Party is a ruling party for the world's second largest economy. And last month, the party had its 19th National Congress. And during that Congress, the party actually mapped out a future plan for the country. To start with, China aims to become a moderately prosperous society by 2020, and then to basically realize socialist modernization by 2035, and then to become a great modern socialist country by the middle of the century.
Also, President Xi proposed to build a community of shared future for mankind at the National Congress of CPC. He also proposed to build a new type of international relations featuring mutual respect, fairness, justice, and women cooperation.
By the way, neighboring countries have always been a priority for China's diplomacy, right? So that also explains well why the president picked up Vietnam as the first overseas country to visit right after the 19th Party Congress.
I think also this year in May, the Vietnamese president visited China to attend the Belt and Road Forum for International Cooperation.
Yes, so long story short, the two parties of the two countries have had frequent exchanges and mutual visits for the past few years, right?
I think the two countries are trying to dock the development strategies such as the Belt and Road Initiative and Vietnam's two corridors and one circle plan.
Yes, so the Belt and Road and Vietnam's two corridors and one economic circle project. So as we said, China has held the 19th Party Congress. And on the other hand, Vietnam is actually well in line with the guidelines set by the Vietnam Communist Party's 12th National Congress. So that means the two parties and the two countries are in the similar process of developing and reforming. And that's where we're looking for complementarity between the two countries' development plans, right? As you mentioned, Belt and Road. And I'm sure lots of you have already heard of Belt and Road Initiative. It was proposed by Chinese President Xi Jinping back in 2013. And it refers to the 21st century maritime Silk Road and the new Silk Road. So it's land-based and sea-based. And together it's called Belt and Road Initiative. And it's actually a network and infrastructure projects linking Asia with Africa and Europe. And of course, each country will find its stalking part with China's Belt and Road Initiative, just like Vietnam. Mm-hmm. Vietnam has its own development projects, and the two countries can find the space for future cooperation, mm-hmm. right?
Also, the both countries going through mm-hmm. reform and opening up,
yes.
and they can find a lot of common grounds mm-hmm. for economic cooperation, such as infrastructure,
yeah.
agriculture,
yeah.
or anything else.
Trade, yeah. Every country, yeah, totally, because Vietnam is by large still an agriculture country. And it has quite rich resources in like iron and steel and coal, right? And on the other hand, China is on its way of being an innovative economy. So we are at different, a little bit different development stages, but we do find our commonalities too.
So yeah. No wonder the two countries have nearly $100 billion
trade, yeah, the trade volume last year.
And China has become Vietnam's largest trading partner. Mm-hmm. Vietnam is also China's largest trading partner in ASEAN.
Yes, so among ASEAN countries.
Yeah.
So basically, from the political front, we have very frequent and friendly exchanges. And on the economic front, the cooperation has been never closer than now, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And I think China and the Vietnam friendship also reflects in the daily life of common uh-huh. Vietnamese people,
yeah.
such as they use Chinese mobile phones.
Oh yes,
Chinese
that
mobile phones
true.
Are very
yeah.
popular in this Southeast country.
Yeah, Chinese cell phones are, I think it's a huge attraction to not only to Vietnam, but also to many other Southeastern Asian countries, and also in Africa, I noticed that. So it's one of our major export products, yeah?
Mm-hmm. Also TV series.
The TVs, yeah.
Yeah, they can translate the Chinese TV series into Vietnamese very quickly and
yeah.
show it to the Vietnamese
yeah.
people.
Yeah. Earlier when I was doing live streaming in Chongqing, like the starting point of the China-Europe freight rail line, I noticed that like the major export products there to other countries in Asia and Europe are actually cell phones and TV sets. All the electronics are quite popular.
Mm-hmm.
And on the other hand, we also like lots of stuff from Vietnam too,
yeah.
right?
Vietnamese coffee.
Yeah, have you tried?
Already.
Really?
How about
oh,
you?
I didn't know. I'm not a coffee person, but I know that and my colleagues in my office actually drink Vietnamese coffee every day.
And yeah. also rice noodle.
Rice noodles, yeah, I did try that last night. It was
great, yeah. The rice noodles in Vietnam, I would say, one of the best.
Yeah, yeah. We also have a lot of Vietnamese restaurants in mm-hmm. Beijing.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, that's true. Like, of course in Beijing you get to try all kinds of global cuisines, but I'm pretty surprised that Vietnamese cuisine is also a popular choice there.
Yeah.
Yeah. And by the way, we only got here one day ago?
Yeah.
Yesterday. And I already noticed that there are a lot of tourists who obviously are speaking Mandarin, so I'm guessing they're tourists from China. And I also noticed that we have like 300 passenger flights every week between China and Vietnam. So China is actually the largest source of foreign tourists to Vietnam.
Mm-hmm.
So that's kind of a quite vibrant exchanges between the peoples, right?
And yesterday we also met some Vietnamese people. They can speak very good
oh,
Chinese.
Yeah, lots of them
yeah.
are learning Chinese, I noticed, yeah.
Yeah.
And one of our colleagues working in our local bureau speak fantastic Chinese, like you couldn't even tell that she is a Vietnamese, right?
Yeah.
I have no clue before they taught us. So lots of young people here in this country are learning Chinese. That's quite impressive, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay. So guys, for those who just joined us, we are correspondents with Xinhua Agency, and we are very glad to be with you guys talking about China-Vietnam bilateral relations as Chinese president is visiting Vietnam right now. And we are inside the Tea House, which is part of the China-Vietnam Friendship Palace, a project wholly sponsored by the Chinese government with a total investment of $50 million almost. And this is a landmark project that was put into construction in 2013, and now it's all done and will be soon put into use and transferred, handed over to local authorities. That means this whole building will be in the use for the local events like ceremonies, culture performances, exchanges. And that's why we just show you the
now the tea house, and also we actually have a TCM therapy room next door, right? And up there on the second floor, we have a library. So this is a multifunctional culture exchange center. So, and it mainly serves for the purpose of exchanges between China and Vietnam, but also this is for Vietnam to have conversations and exchanges with the rest of the world, not just China, right?
The world. Yes.
And we're quite surprised to find all kinds of Chinese elements here. Of course, this is sponsored by Chinese government and built by Chinese companies, but it all melts like all different cultural aspects kind of meet each other here. Mm-hmm. Like earlier, I noticed inside the main hall of this building, they have this huge wall painting. It was donated by the Chinese Academy of Fine Arts. And if you pay attention, you could find the huge bronze drum. Mm-hmm. And the drum is actually a culture symbol of not only China, but also Vietnam. So all these people involved in these projects are looking for cultural symbols that can represent both countries.
Mm-hmm.
And also, did you find all this, the paintings of the ethnic people, like they're looking, and the sceneries are similar too. So they're looking for similarities and commonalities between the two countries to be blend into this building.
Yeah. Maybe we can go outside to have a overall looking of this
Let's
building.
Go outside, cool. Just love this place. Have you tried all those tea ceremonies like in southern China? It's quite popular, the whole tea ceremony.
Uh-huh. Yeah. I think the tea are very similar in China and in Vietnam.
The same?
Yeah.
Oh, I haven't tried it yet, but we should go, definitely go and try the tea and coffee. And we often say tea and coffee are where the East meet the West, right?
Yeah.
Outside, and now we're taking you to the outlook and outside view of this China-Vietnam Friendship Palace. I'm sure like this building will be a landmark and across the city.
Yeah, exactly.
Shall we go? Yeah, let's go there. The weather's fine today, right?
Yeah.
And yeah, guys, let us know if you have any questions in terms of China-Vietnam relations, and we'll get back to you soon because we are not able to see the screens right now, but we'll get back to you to your questions. So do not hesitate to share your comments and questions. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's pretty cool here. What is
so
much warmer than Beijing?
It's a round shaped outside.
Oh yes, have a look at this building. I'm gonna explain a bit later. Yeah. It's pretty hard to film everything about the building with the cell phone. So we've got this huge painting here that gives you a broad view of this building here. So it's round shaped, and actually inside is pretty square shaped. And if you look from above, this is actually in the shape of a lotus, and lotus is the national flower of Vietnam. This is all well thought, right? All right, it's pretty cool, right? And as we said earlier, for this live streaming, we are taking you on an adventure to look for the evidence of China-Vietnam cooperation and friendship. And this is only our first stop, the China-Vietnam Friendship Palace. And so where are we going next? I've got a map, actually.
Yeah.
Okay. So, yeah, this is too small for all of you. It's just the city map. And back here, we got all the places of interest, like the Hoan Kiem Lake. And we also have West Lake, the largest one. And we have the very famous Angkor Wat Mausoleum. And we have the Kim Liên Pagoda. And we have the Flower Market. And also the Hanoi Temple of Literature. And the St. Joseph Cathedral.
and Long Biên Bridge. So basically, the city is lots of fun. It should be worth exploring for a day or two at least, right? But unfortunately, we're not going to take you to any of those. Sorry, guys. So what are we going to do next? You have to stay tuned and find out with us together.
Traveling across the city of Hanoi, capital of Vietnam. As we told you earlier that we were looking for evidence of China-Vietnam close cooperation across the city, and our first stop was the China-Vietnam Friendship Palace, and now we're taking you to the next stop. So try to make a guess as we are filming the traffic on the road. Perhaps you have noticed that we have lots of motorbikes in the city. People here are just a big fan of this, right? It's good for transportation, it's convenient. But Stu, did you notice that we haven't encountered with a metro line or a subway here? Not really yet. And we are exploring along the way. So stay with us, let us know if you have any questions. And try to make a guess on our next stop. I will let you know in a second. For those who have not been to Vietnam before, it's a socialist country ruled by Vietnam's Communist Party, and it's located in Southeast Asia. It's actually a neighbor of China. And as of the China-Vietnam bilateral relations, we've had a long history of exchange and mutual learning dating back to ancient times. And in modern times, since 2008, China and Vietnam have established a comprehensive strategic cooperative partnership. And right now, Chinese President Xi Jinping is paying a state visit to this country. And as we are following the president's overseas trips, that's why we are in Hanoi right now. Enjoy the street views and let us know your interests, your questions. This is our first time to be in Hanoi. I did a bit of research earlier. This what attracts me the most is actually local food. So Vietnam is known for very delicious street food. And we are pretty close to our destination. As we said, the second clue or evidence of China Vietnam close cooperation in nowadays. Vietnam is actually a popular destination for Chinese tourists. As a matter of fact, China is Vietnam's largest source of foreign tourists. And we said earlier that there are about 300 passenger flights every week between the two countries. And also the two countries have lots of cooperation in trade, investment. Last year, the total trade volume between China and Vietnam actually reached nearly $100 billion. In the whole city, the structure looks pretty much like a Chinese city. We
we share lots of similarities. We are both socialist countries. We are both ruled by a communist party, and we are both going through reform and development. I hope you guys enjoy the ride so far, and just be a little bit patient with us. We are pretty close.
Who just tuned in or who already followed our program, once again, we are correspondents with Xinhua News Agency, and we are following Chinese President Xi Jinping's overseas trips. And today we are in Hanoi. We're trying to take you on an adventure to look for the evidence of China-Vietnam close cooperation. And this is our second stop, right?
Yes.
Yeah. And where did we go earlier?
Actually, the Vietnam-China Friendship Palace.
Yeah.
Where we are now?
So guys, have a look around us. As you can see, we are taking the stairs and we're trying to get to the metro station. But the fact is, the city doesn't have a metro system yet. Uh-huh. And this is a metro construction project. So in a few years, Hanoi is going to have its first metro line in the city. Mm-hmm. Actually, this is the city center, so mm-hmm. it's a very crowded region. And it goes from up there and goes across the city center and through lots of universities, schools, right?
Yeah, yeah. You can see the very, very busy traffic, heavy traffic,
yeah.
lot of mobile bikes, lot yeah. of cars here.
Yeah.
We also suffer some traffic jam when we come here, actually.
And we showed you earlier how bad the traffic could be in this city. And lots of people take the motorbikes, right? But with metro system coming, I'm sure the city life will be a lot easier.
Yeah. So why we say it's evidence of mm-hmm. China-Vietnam friendship?
Because this is a project supported by China, the China Railway Engineering Corporation, a Chinese enterprise specialized in railway construction.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And actually, this project started from 2011, year mm-hmm. 2011.
Yes.
And it will soon be completed, actually, as early as in next year.
Yeah.
And also, how long?
Oh, this one, we were just told earlier, the whole metro system for this, I would say line one, because it's the yeah. first one, right?
Yeah.
It's about 13 kilometers long, mm-hmm. and it has 12 stops.
Yeah.
So let's go up there and have a look at this metro system, which is still under construction. And we get the privilege to get actually on the rails of the trains, right?
Uh-huh.
So guys, join us and let us know if you have any questions.
Yeah,
let's go. We should take the stairs here. Okay, yeah, over there. This is brand new here because it's still not complete yet,
yeah,
right?
Still in yeah. construction.
And by the time it's complete, this will be one of the metro stations in the city center of Hanoi.
Yeah. yeah.
Be careful, guys, though. So we're about to get to the platform.
Mm-hmm.
Although it's still under construction, but this is like a model. And like lots of companies and people will come here to have a visit, although it's not done yet. Just like us, we're trying to know the progress of this project. And as we said earlier, the metro system could be put into commercial use by the end of next year.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Let's go.
And we are told all the workers who are working here are
yeah.
from Vietnam, the local workers.
Labor workers, yeah. And can we have a look at the trains here? It looks like exactly the same as the trains in Beijing or
yeah,
Shanghai, right?
Yeah.
All these trains here, let's have a look. We can't really get a close shot inside the trains, but it's the metro system quite similar to those trains in Beijing or Shanghai, because these are all Chinese designed and manufactured.
Yeah.
yeah. from from here, we get to have a great view. Can our camera guy just show us around here? Let's see the view from the platform and the rail of the under construction metro system in the city center of Hanoi. Wow. It's quite a view here, right? We are standing on the second floor, which is the platform of Hanoi's future railway station. Enjoy the view, guys. Yeah.
General manager, the person in charge of this project, Mr. Tang Hong, speak with us. So, how many workers once worked for this project?
多少工人？目前是三四百人。现在已经项目的土建已经接近尾声。
都是越南人吗？
工人都是越南人。
So this China Railway Engineering Company has hired 300 to 400 local employees. They all come from Vietnam.
最高峰的时候呢，达到每天六千人。
6000人。
最高峰的时候。
现在是3400人。
对，现在已经接近尾声了。
So as the project is near completion, they have hired 300 to 400 local workers for everyday construction. But previously, during the peak of the construction, they actually hired thousands of local workers for this project. Go over there. So what you're looking at is the motto of China Railway Engineering Company. The Chinese motto says, innovation holds the dream of the time, and made in China makes what is, makes it wonderful. So that's quite ambitious. 还是很有追求，很有梦想。
是的，因为这条轻轨啊。全部采用的是中国标准、中国技术和中国装备，所以说我们要把中国制造啊，要推向世界。
所以6000多人都是越南的话，那 speak English or Chinese？
Yeah, it's fine.
OK， 就是如果6000个工人都是越南的话，我们是有不断有工程人员来教他们技术的。
是的，因为。因为这条现在在越南是首条，很多建筑技术、建设技术啊，在越南他们是没有的。我们很多都是要从中国先派来专业技术人员啊，熟练工人先教他们，先做一段教他们，教会以后，我们的这个专业人员就走了，就交给他们来做。
It's all the technologies, facilities, and the standards here are from China, so it's a made in China train system.And as they have implied local employees, but still at the beginning, they need training programs. And we've got technicians and experts from China to train local workers to help them get onto the project.
How long have you been working here?
在这里工作多长时间？ 我在这里工作了有两年半了。
So this manager here has been working for this project for 2.5 years.
Yeah.
This is going to be Hanoi's first urban metro system. Yeah. It's a great view here. I'm really surprised though. 这个地方景色很好啊，其实视野很开阔。
是的，是的。这个这条轻轨修建完以后啊，实际上也是一道观光旅游线啊。对，从这上面。这个开车一路走过去啊，能够从另外一个平常在地面达不到的角度，哎，来欣赏这个河内市的美景。
He just said that upon completion of this project, this is going to be a view, a place of interest, a tourist attraction actually for locals and people from outside Vietnam, and it gives you a chance to look at the city from a completely different angle.Like the view here. How do you like it so far?
Pardon?
Yeah. How do you like the views here? I will just go from here.
Magnificent.
Yeah. Sorry.
Yeah. Magnificent.
Yeah. It's actually my first time to stand and walk on the rails.
Walk between the lines.
Yeah, I know. And Hanoi
now it has its traffic jam problems, right? As we told you earlier, this Hanoi's first metro line will have 13 kilometer with 12 stops, and it goes through universities, schools, and other public institutions. So I'm sure that it will be a great help for especially young people to travel between places, right? Yeah.
Because it runs through universities, hospitals, and governmental departments.
Yeah.
Also for this metro system, it's with a total investment of $650 million.
Mm-hmm.
And they also imported some trains and carriages from China.
Yes. So do you remember we said earlier the total investment of the China-Vietnam Friendship Palace was nearly $50 million. And for this metro system here, the total investment for the whole project is $650 million, which is 13 times of that palace project, right? And as my colleague just said, like the trains were imported from China.
Yeah, and it created a lot of job opportunities
For
the locals.
Yeah. And speaking of jobs here, we've got some local workers here. I think they have had a pretty rough day already. So let's go have a few shots there.
Can they speak English?
No. Okay. For the construction workers here, they work 8 hours a day. That's normal standard, right? Yeah. We could actually walk all the way of the 13 kilometers.
可以一直往前走了。可以啊，可以啊。到头。啊，对。现在轨道已经通了。我们现在的轨道车就在上面在运行。轨道车一方面是 检测线路，同时也作为我们的运料工具，一直在上面跑着呢。现在可以。所以其实已经基本上建好了，是吗？对，轨道都已经通了，现在就是没有设备没有安装完，系统还没有进行调试，所以说现在只能是轨道车来回来进行运料送料。So
actually, the trains and the rails all the construction of the trains and rails have been done, and all we need for now is the supporting facilities. So, 这个项目要明年年底是吧？明年年底。 By the end of next year, this Hanoi's first metro line will be ready for commercial use. Okay. Thank you, guys. Let's just sit here and talk. It's really nice, and never tried this before. Since this metro line is not into operation yet. So yeah, it's pretty fun here.
Yeah.
So guys, we hope that you have enjoyed our live streaming so far. We're in Hanoi and we have taken you to the China-Vietnam Friendship Palace and to the train station, which is still under construction by China Railway Engineering Corporation. And this is going to be Hanoi's first urban metro line.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And we're looking for evidence of the bilateral cooperation and friendship between the two socialistic countries. And the reason is that Chinese President Xi Jinping is in Vietnam for a state visit and also for the APEC summit. Did you have fun?
Fun. Yeah. I think it's very solid evidence for China-Vietnam friendship.
Yeah. Actually, we have plenty more of the evidence in city center. If you come to Hanoi, you walk around, you will get, you will come across with lots of Chinese tourists, and you will see all the Chinese language signs as in the tourist places too, right?
Mm-hmm.
So the two countries have very close relations in terms of political cooperation, economic cooperation, and cultural exchanges. Yeah. Okay, so it's been really fun with you guys together, and let us know if you have further comments, and see you next time. Bye.
Bye.
you.